Okay, so we're doing Rwandan cats eating UK cat treats. So I've just got back from the UK and I have brought so many varieties of cat treat. So we shall be rating the cat treats from like 0 to a bajillion on how much Rwandan cats like British cat treats. Now, I already know that they really like cheesy dreamies because we've already done these. So let me just put you down for a moment. Okay, so cheesy dreamies are just like tiny little thumbnail sized pieces of cheesy cat treat. As you can see, they know that they already like these. Let's have a little bit of cheesy dreamies. There we go. Okay, so that's a 10 out of 10 on cheesy dreamies for Rwandan cats.
Okay, we're about to have a massive thunderstorm here. So the next one we're on is another packet of dreamies with tempting beef. Yeah, I reckon we're probably going to be fine with these. So these ones are much darker than the cheese ones, but I'm just assuming they love dreamies of any flavour. Have a look, girls, boys. What do we think? Yeah, definitely enjoying the dreamies. There was a little bit of purring going on there. All right, so it's absolutely chipping it down today, and we're gonna try something a bit different. These are called Nibbly Cat Treats Ocean Wraps, sorry, by Cat It. And I found these in a slightly, I found these in a slightly gourmet pet food shop in the UK, so I thought, we'll give them a go. They are the strangest looking cat treats I've ever seen. They're like tiny little fish bits, like you can actually see the fish heads in there. I mean, here in Rwanda, the cats would usually eat indagara as a snack, but they really don't like it very much. That's sort of dried white bait. So this is very similar. Oh my goodness, this has got a seriously fishy smell to it, seriously fishy. And it came with like a stay dry pouch, one of those little things to keep it dry, but it kind of reminded me of the flavoring that you get in instant noodles. So kind of like Instameal. All right, let's see. This one here is Sophie, and Sophie is a very picky eater. So if it gets the Sophie seal of approval, then it's good. Sophie's not too sure about it. She's picking at it. So if Sophie eats it, then it's good. The other two, this is Hal and this is Sen, and they will eat absolutely anything you put in front of them. But Sophie's not so sure about this. Nope, she's not so sure about it. Okay, darling. So that gets a 2 out of 3. Okay, so this morning we're opening the big packet of Go Cat Crunchy and Tender cat treats, because we've kind of run out of actual cat food, and this is the biggest bag of treats I've got, so they shall be breakfasting on Go Cat. So this one is salmon and tuna with a mix of vegetables. Let's see what they think. So this one, we have little pellets with some chunky bits in between. So I'm guessing the little pellets are the mixture of vegetables and the chunky bits are the salmon and tuna. They're a bit distracted by somebody at the gate, so they're eating it and they're purring, but they're also distracted, so it hasn't got 100% of their attention. All right, so there's still no kibble available in Rwanda, so I'm going to use up this treat bag of Felix for their morning snack, which is a goodie bag of seaside mix. And it looks kind of interesting. Let's see what's in there. I'm kind of disappointed by this because, like, on the packet, these little fishy looking ones are bright pink. But in reality, they're the same color as everything else. So, yeah, let's see what they think. Well, two of them are into it. But Sophie does not appear interested at all. Oh, yeah, there we go. Yep, Felix Mixed Bag seems to be going down very well indeed.
Okay, it's another very rainy day today, and we're going to go for Felix Play Tubes. Now, I did actually get one of those plastic play balls that releases food, and I thought they might enjoy that, but they showed absolutely no interest in it. And the next day it was full of ants, so I had to throw it away. But yeah, let's give these a go. So play tubes do look a little bit like, I guess, elongated Cheerios for cats. And because it's such a horrible rainy day, let's have a go at eating them in the Bahamas.
Yep, they are definitely enjoying Felix Play Tubes. That's definitely a hit.
Okay, so today we have some more Dreamies, and this time they are with Delectable Duck. Okay, so Delectable Duck are, hello darling, Delectable Duck are a little bit darker than the cheese ones and a little bit lighter than the beef ones. So here we go. Delectable Duck.
Alright, here's some weird ones. So we're back to Catit Nibbly Bits again, and this time they're called Chicken Grills. And I'm just fascinated. Everything that Catit make looks really, really strange. So let's take a look.
Alright, so these are like really, really paper thin slivers of like treat in two different colours. So like the fish one, this one has quite a strong smell, very chickeny smell. It smells good.
Try it over here and see what you think of this. Oh, there's some purring going on here. No, they definitely like these ones. They weren't too sure about the fish, but they really like the chicken. Oh, hello, darling. Sophie's a very fussy eater, but nope, she's eating it. She's, don't know, you're not too sure.
Okay, so today we're on crunchy filled pockets with chicken and cheese.
Okay, we like those so much, we're going to have some more. Oh, okay, maybe that's a little bit too much.
All right, time for another packet of Catit Nibbly Bits, and these ones are chicken grills. I beg your pardon. Okay. So again, these are very, very thin looking little pieces of treat. So I don't know how easy it is for them to actually pick them up, but they do appear to like, oh yeah, look at this, look at this. Ooh. Oh yeah, we got a little bit of looking going on here.
I think out of all of the nibbly bits, this is definitely their favourite one.
Okay guys, today is a bit of a difficult day because this is our very last packet of cat treats from the UK, made with 95% meat, and we don't ask about the other five. But there's currently a massive pet food shortage in Rwanda, and none of the pet food is coming through. It's all been sort of lost at a port somewhere. So for the time being, This is the last proper cat food, kiddly cat food, that these guys are going to have for a very long time, unless something magical happens. So I really hope that they like it. Oh, this one smells really stinky. I'm not going to put that on my hand. I'm just going to, let's just put it on here. Oh, that's stinky. All right, if I save a little bit for tonight or tomorrow morning. And here we go. These are, what are these called again? Nature's Menu, treats with chicken and turkey. All right, I get the feeling that these are really stinky and therefore probably quite yummy. Let's see, what do you think, kids? Oh yes, there's a strong amount of purring going on there.
Okay, so through my scientific research study of cats, sorry, this is the newest cat. Excuse me, darling. it seems that the overall winner is this weird one that I've never heard of before called Nature's Menu, treats with chicken and turkey, and that seems to be the overall winner, followed by anything to do with Dreamies. I'd probably go beef, cheese, and then duck.
Then the next favourite was this Nibbly Bits, Cat Nibbly Bits Grills, which was the only Nibbly Bits one that they really liked. Yeah, my darling. Crunchy Pockets after that with chicken and cheese. Chicken Time Soft Snacks by Carney Loves. Then anything by Felix went down very well. I think they preferred the chicken and liver to the seafood one. Hello, darling. then they got stuck into the go-kart. And finally, at the bottom, we've got these Nibbly Bits ones, which two of the three thought were okay. But yeah, that's pretty much the cat tasting done. And in my scientific, heavily controlled conditions of this research, it appears that cats anywhere in the world will eat anything.